how am I gonna find my husband if I'm staying in the house and I'm not going nowhere? Like, I'm not even, I don't even like going to the grocery store.
Like, they're so cute. I actually love it.
Hi friends, good morning. I hope everyone's having a blessed day as you are watching this video. If you don't know who I am, my name is Najee Kayvon, and I do everything motherhood, lifestyle, and faith. That is my overall platform all across the board. So welcome if you are new, welcome back if you've been here. The last time y'all saw me was my St. Martin vlog when I went to celebrate my 30th birthday, and I decided to continue to vlog because my consistency sucks, and I always talk about in my videos how I want to just be consistent, but I've been making every excuse in the world as to why I can't create, because I always feel like I don't have anything to create. But there's so many things that I be doing that I can definitely be picking up my camera to show y'all and do that can be a small little vlog. So decided to start this week. It is, what's today? It's Tuesday. I'm currently at work. I'm an hour early because I do have to drive an hour and 30 minutes to my job. And I'm an hour early. It's actually 5:25 a.m. I'm supposed to be here at 6:30. So after I record this video, I'm probably going to go to sleep and like take me a little nap or whatever. But I do clock in at 6:30. So I have a very early day. I'll be off like around 10 o'clock. And then I just have the rest of the day to do what I want to do. This is my part-time job currently. But I have recently, I'm holding y'all down here by the way, because my little mount thing that I usually put on my car window, it broke. So I don't really have anything to hold my camera. So the ghetto. But I'm sorry. But anyway, this is my part-time job currently. And I do still work my full-time job. However, I have put in notice at my full-time job that I do not want to move forward with my career there. And so these are pretty much my last few weeks there. I have worked there for 7+ years, and I have just finally decided to like let it go. I loved working there. However, like this last store that I've worked at, because this was my third store with the company, I just feel like it burnt me out, and it's just a little more demanding on me, my body, and my life, and a lot more demanding in the ways that is not healthy for me. So I decided that I want to just part ways with them and move on into my part-time job, which I love, and just grow here because I love it here. It's a great work environment. I make a lot of money here. And it's just me. I get to dress up instead of in uniform, so I don't have to manage people anymore because I'm not a manager. But eventually that is the goal, to like get into that, because my position that I'm in full time, I am a manager, so I manage people all day. I don't know, I think just in that type of environment, in the traditional retail world, it's just too much for me, like too much to carry every day. And while I love it, I do feel like just for that particular place and that job, like I'm cool. Like I think I've done enough of it. Like I said, I've been there for 7 years. That's the longest job I've ever held, because I am a quitter when it comes to jobs. Like I will quit so quick. I'm not even gonna lie to you. Like I will quit a job quick, fast, and in a hurry, because I'm one of those people that believe in not letting a job stress you out, and just not allowing a job to take over your life because they don't care about you. Like that's what I believe. So when a job starts giving me those vibes that like I cannot grow here, I cannot thrive here, and it's being stressful on my mind, my body, I have to go. So it's come to the point where that job has become very much that times 100. And I'm just like, I can't do it anymore. Like, I'm trying to stick it out, but I can't do it anymore. So I told them I don't want to move forward with my career after this month. And I don't see myself growing with them any further. So I would like to part ways. So I did my exit interview. I did my resignation. I said I'll be done at the end of the month. But yeah, I am ready to just start this new chapter. I didn't know what I would do. I just haven't ever like been without a full-time job, so that's scary. But this job in particular, even though I am part-time, now that my availability will open up, I will have a lot more availability to be here, which was what they need, because I do make a lot more money here too part-time than I do in my full-time position. So I know I'll be okay. And plus, I know God is not going to allow me to be in a space that I can't handle, and he's not gonna let me suffer. So I'm okay, and I'm going to be okay, and I know everything's gonna work out exactly how it's supposed to work out. But I know and felt that in that current position, or in that position, like, it was time for me to go. And I kept feeling the conviction to leave. So I know that was God telling me, this is not what I had planned for you. This is not what I want for you. I went ahead and just ripped the band-aid off. But it was uncomfortable at first, I'm not gonna lie. But anyway, today, since I do have a very short day, I want to do my nails. I got these press-ons that is a different shape. Like, y'all know I'm like the square girly, like tapered square. That's my shape. But I feel like I just need to grow up and try the almond shape. So I bought these almond shape like French tip press-ons, and I want to try them and see, you know, how they fit me, how they look, and see if I can really be an almond girly now. I don't know. And then I also want to try this recipe that I saw on Instagram, because it's October, it's fall, that means it's soup season. I love soups, and I want to try like all the soups and like hearty meals that I can find. And so I saw this like really delectable, is that the word, for this meal on Instagram. Like, it was chickpeas, but it looked like kind of like stewy caramelized chickpeas on top of rice, and it just looks so good because I like chickpeas. So I was like, let me try that. And I'm also trying to eat healthier too, because I'm trying to change my habits, also gym. So kind of have a lot to do low key today, if I actually commit to it, and I need to commit to it. So those are the plans, but we will see how I feel, because like I'm already tired low key right now. And I'm about to try to take this nap before I have to start work, because I still have a whole hour before work I have to clock in. And then, like, when I get off, I have to drive 1:30 back home. So it all depends on, like, the energy that I have. Like, I want to be able to go back home, go ahead and get dressed and go to the gym, and then shower, take a nap. But I feel like if I take a nap, it's over for everything. It's over for everything. But the one thing I know for real that I most likely will do is go to the gym, or even do like the workout in the house, because I do have weights and stuff in the house for me to do in the house, because sometimes I don't feel comfortable going to the gym. Like, I don't know why I'm so scared of the gym, y'all. Like, and it's just my apartment gym, because I'm not going to like a real gym. A real gym I'm really scared of. Like, I don't know why, but I'm just too scared. Like, the anxiety of going to a real gym just scares me, like, and just people being there, like, I don't like it. So, and then, like, even with my apartment gym, like, I don't want to go in there if somebody's in there. If somebody's in there, I don't want to work out. Like, get out. I want the room to myself. And that's why, like, I just feel like I'll probably be a home workout girly and just do everything in the house. Like, I even saw this Pilates thing that I was gonna buy on Amazon, like the whole like reformer. I want to get all that so I could just stay in the house and do these. Like, I don't want to go around people. It just feels weird to me. But then I feel like I'm never going to find my husband because I'm always in the house. But it don't have nothing to do with a man for real. But just saying, like, the fact that I, like, am so confined to my home and I just love to be at home, like, how do I expect to align myself with friends, with my people? Like, you know what I mean? Because I stay in the house, like, I don't feel like I have, like, basically I'm, like, one of those people that desire, like, a group of friends so I can host parties for and, you know, host events for whatever, because, like, I want to host things. Like, I'm a Virgo. Like, I love to do that. I love to gift people. And my desires are to have a big group of friends to be able to do stuff like that with and have those cute little girls' nights and those type of things, or just having a group of friends to travel with. But I don't go outside to meet people, and that's the problem. And then, obviously, I desire to be in love. I desire to be in a relationship. I desire to have a husband. But how am I going to find my husband if I'm staying in the house and I'm not going nowhere? Like, I'm not even, I don't even like going to the grocery store. So, how am I going to find him? Because it ain't going to be on the internet. Child, I don't want no man from the internet. But, yeah, that's pretty much where we at with it. I feel like I will take a nap because I am very tired. But, y'all, I've been watching Love is Blind. We gotta discuss this because I don't know, the editing is kind of weird, because I'm just like, why do they be staying on some of the scenes so long? Like, one of the scenes last night I was watching was with Taylor and I don't know her fiance's name, the guy, but like the couple where he's always like, I got that dog in me, like him. Like, in the pods, I loved them. Like, they were so, like, cute. And, like, I was getting all teary-eyed and jerked up every time he would tell the stories about his sisters and stuff. But, like, outside of the pods, it seemed like she was annoyed with him. Like, she don't like him. Like, she basically hates him. That's what I was getting the vibes of. And then, like, he's just so oblivious and clueless to the fact that, like, he's getting on her nerves. And then, like, the scene where, I guess, by the way, I'm sorry. If y'all ain't watch it, y'all better watch it and stop this video because I'm about to spoil it. But in the scene where, like, you know, they got in the fight or whatever, and she was basically telling him to stay and, like, hugging him. Why did they stay on the scene, like, just slow zooming on his face, like, for 5 minutes, bruh? I was just like, what the heck? And I was like, this is so awkward. And I was just like, so whoever is editing Love is Blind, they need to get fired, like, for real, because they're making it uncomfortable. Like, every scene they be making uncomfortable between the couples, and, like, all the awkward silences and stares back and forth at each other, and it's just weird. Like, especially when, what's her name, Steven and old girl, like the Miss America girl or Miss Universe, I don't know their names, I don't be paying attention to their names, but then when she was like, he was talking about the couples and stuff, and then she was just like basically telling him to shut up because he was talking too much. That was hilarious to me, and I'm just like, dang, like, let him talk. And I would feel like, in that moment, if I was Steven, I would have been like, dang, she don't love me because she don't want me to talk. Like, if you love me, you gonna let me ramble. And then she was just like, let me talk. And she wasn't even talking. She just kept eating and staring at him. So I'm just like, bro, what do you want him to stop talking for if you ain't gonna say nothing? And he's just looking at her like, are you gonna say something? And she's just looking at him like, what? And I'm just like, bro, the scenes are just too awkward. It is so funny to me. And it also, it's just like so bad because I'm just like, why are you guys editing like this? Like, what the heck? But let me stop talking because I didn't take a nap. I'm about to talk to y'all for a whole hour for no reason and be tired as hell when I gotta clock in. So let me take a nap. I'm off work now. I'm actually trying to find me somewhere to eat because I got off earlier than I thought. I thought I was getting off at like 10:30. I got off at 9:30. So now I'm trying to find me something to eat around here. All right, y'all. So it looks like we're going to Snooze because it's literally 3 minutes away around the corner. So that's where we're gonna go eat. And I've been to Snooze before, so I kind of already know their menu, and they're not too expensive, so I'm gonna go eat there, sit in there for a little bit. So I'll see y'all when I get to Snooze. I hate that my hoodie is kind of like the wrong
color black because it's faded, but let me pay for my parking, y'all. This food is not good. It's not that good. But I'm hungry, so I don't care. This is a blueberry lemonade though. This is good. Alright, so I just finished breakfast. And if I'm like, if I think I'm right, maybe I need to go the way I came in because I'm gonna be lost. Yeah, let's just go the way I came in because I'm definitely gonna be lost. I just saw a parking deck and I thought it was a shortcut, which I'm sure it is, but it's a side of the parking deck that I just don't know. So I'm not going that way. But that breakfast was very mid. I did not like it. Child, I don't know where I'm going. I'm like just lost and stuck. But it's getting a little warmer outside, but yeah. The breakfast was like a little mid, low key. Not gonna lie. It was kind of like, first of all, I've only had corned beef hash. I got corned beef hash in a pancake. And y'all, they got mowers right here. I can't even talk because I know y'all not gonna hear me. So let's just wait till we get in the car.
Okay, so unfortunately, I gotta put y'all to the side because like I said, I don't have my car mount no more. It broke. And even if I wanted to fix it, I can't find it in my car. So this is how we gotta talk. I know the lighting is like whatever, but we're improvising. We're not making any more excuses why we can't vlog. Anyway, the food. So I got corned beef hash, and then I got this buttermilk pancake, and it honestly was not good. Like, it was straight. Yes. No, it wasn't even straight. It was like, it was good enough to eat because I was hungry, but it was actually pretty nasty. And like, when I first tried corned beef hash, I tried it at this restaurant in Greensboro. Cannot remember the name right now. It's like the only restaurant that everybody goes to for brunch on the weekends for the most part, especially because it's like one of the only good ones in Greensboro, and I just cannot think of the name of it right now. But it's downtown, and they have corned beef hash, and that corned beef hash is so good. And just the way they present it, and it's just so good. It was so good. So I was just like, dang, I like corned beef hash. But like Snooze, their corned beef hash is like, how do I explain it? It's just, it looked like Waffle House would have made it, basically. Like, with those kind of hash browns and then just chunks of corned beef, I guess, that probably came out of a can. Like, it was nasty. And I was like, whatever. And then they had the eggs with the scrambled cheese. Like, basically, Snooze was like a bougie Waffle House to me. That's what all the food looked and tasted like. I mean, not saying Waffle House is nasty, because Waffle House is actually good, but the way the food was presented, it looks like Waffle House food, or like IHOP or something. And yeah, it wasn't giving. But I was hungry. I haven't eaten anything. I've been up since 3 a.m. and have not eaten anything. So I was just like, I don't even care anymore. I just want to eat. I'm hungry. So ate that. And now I'm on my way home. But because I don't have anywhere to mount y'all, I'm going to go ahead and just see y'all when I get home. Magnify the Lord with me.
Come on, sing it to him, sing it.
Whom the sun he has redeemed.
Come on.
You are the Lord of
everything. You are Lord of all. I will bless the Lord. Bless the Lord at all times.
Come on, if you want
to. We'll be talking, I don't entertain. I'm broken in faith. Could I do good at this rate? Don't you think like that?
Within a world of darkness, open up the curtains on my darkest shadows. When the time is precious, when it's borrowed, your love is something that I need.
It is almost 4 o'clock. It's like 3:30. I just woke up. Yeah, it's already 4 o'clock. It's like 3:55. So let's go to Walmart, y'all. All right, we're going to beauty store first. Beauty store first, Walmart, and then back home. Nowhere else, nothing else. All right, let's go.
I'm gonna make it through.
Change it on a good part too. Lord, that was my part. But I'm about to go in this store. I'm not taking my camera because it's too big, but I will record on my phone. It's not much to record though, but I'll record on my phone. So I'll see y'all in a little bit. It looks like I have to buy me a new tripod, guys, because I'm just never really prepared for all this stuff. So I'm gonna just sit y'all up here on my fridge because that works. Okay, I need to clean up real bad. So that is what I'm gonna do tonight after I do my nails, or I should do it before I do my nails. Yeah, I'm gonna clean up before I do my nails, and then we're gonna do my nails. I'm about to go ahead and make me some rolls for my lasagna soup so I can eat, because I am getting a little hungry, and we'll prep. And then after I do my nails, we'll make my overnight oats for tomorrow. I did finish my nails. I want to get out the way so it can focus on my nails. I actually don't hate them. I was really, really scared about obviously changing my nail shape, because this is the first time I ever did another nail shape outside of squared and tapered square. I've never, ever done a different nail shape. And guys, I'm actually kind of obsessed, low key. Like, they're so cute. I actually love it. But it is 8:30. I'm about to get ready to go to bed. I just want to go ahead and make my overnight oats with you guys so you guys can see what I do and what my little recipe is, because it's fire every time. Though I hate seeing like the ones on TikTok and stuff, because, or TikTok and Instagram, how they do their overnight oats, because like the way people do it on TikTok, or at least the videos I've seen, they don't be doing nothing. Like, they oats be nasty, I know for sure, because all they do is milk, some granola, and maybe like a pinch of cinnamon or something, I don't know, with some fruit. No, they oatmeal don't got no flavor. So I'm about to show y'all what I do to make my oatmeal, and then I'm going to get a few Bible verses in before bed, and I also want to try to read my book, because let me show y'all. I have this book right here, A Little More Life,
And the reason why I got it is because I saw a TikTok review of this girl who was basically saying, like, this book is going to tear you up. You won't even be able to read it. I low-key think I need to start over because, for one, my son lost my bookmark, so I have no idea where I stopped. I wasn't too far into the book yet either, so I think I'm just going to start over and then try to get through it by the... I'm not going to say the end of the month. I'm going to be realistic. Because it's like October 16th already, or it's me the 16th tomorrow. So, at least get through half of the book by the end of the month. So, I am going to start over and read it because I don't know where I stopped at. And I do kind of want to start over anyway because just as I was reading, it was really hard to like go along with the story just the way the author narrates the book, I guess. I don't know. But I just need to get into it so I can see. But I really want to cry. I want it to make me feel all that. And I hope it does. And it's that good. So I'm going to read a little bit of that too before I go to bed. But yeah, I do have to get up early. So I don't know for sure if I'm going to read too much. Because I am obviously tired. Even though I took a nap today, which is weird. So yeah. And I have to pee really bad. So let's go ahead and make these oats. Or let me go pee first.
Turn up in the summer. I got sent off in the thumping. Fit is how I'm coming. They've been waiting on this word to drop. My whole life been better. Ain't about this God and now I'm high. Holy Spirit on my brain. I need to tango. Soul of the Spirit is my weapon. Keep that thing close. Run without scripts. Out the bed or the bankroll. In the rain, what is stress for? I'm a dog and I don't care about your opinion. Good, better watch the way you talk to me, I'm vicious. You can't tell me where I'm going, tunnel vision. I ain't like nothing that you seen before, I'm dead. I just can't go back, I can't throw back, throw back. Turn up into something, I got sent off in the dumping. Faith is how I'm coming, they been waiting on this word to drop. My whole life been better, baby, that just got it, now I'm high.
Stay with God, so why would you play with me? Got my sword on my hip and it stay with me. Jezebel get the step and can't lay with me. I'm a preacher, don't...
Alright, y'all. The oatmeal is now done. That's going to sit in the fridge overnight. And I'm going to go ahead and get ready for bed. So I'm going to end the vlog here tonight for today. And then we will continue tomorrow when I do my hair. Because I'm going to do my pixie tomorrow. So I will see you guys tomorrow. Good night.
Let me tell you about my Lord and Savior. The one that's great, the one that's great, the Lord and Savior. Let me tell you about my Lord and Savior. The one that's great, the one for great, the Lord and Savior.
I still feel like I might play with it a little bit more and like maybe do a little more cutting because I feel like this side here is just a little too long in certain areas. So I just need to shave it down a little bit to frame my face a little more. But for now, it's cute enough. I really wanted like a darker brown than this because this is like an orangish, like an orange type of brown. But obviously they don't have that kind of, the brown that I'm looking for, they're just not going to have in like these kind of things. But let y'all see. I still think it's really cute though. Like from a distance it looks brown, but it's just, I just really wanted like a dark brown. Like to not where it's like black, but just, you know it's brown. But, yeah, I'm done. I have to clean up the bathroom because now my bathroom is a hot mess. So, y'all, I did want to go ahead and end the vlog here. I just want to first show you guys a new recipe that I decided to try. I got this recipe from Instagram, and it is just like sauteed mushrooms, onions, and chickpeas over rice. I've been trying to eat healthier, just eat cleaner meals, and I love chickpeas, so I thought that this would be a really good meal to try. It was very quick and easy, and if you guys want the recipe, I can definitely link the YouTube of the lady that I found the recipe from. But all I did was make dinner to end off my week, and then I went to try to catch up with The Lincoln Lawyer because that is my show and the new season just came out. But if you made it to the end of the video, thank you so much for watching. And if you have not yet subscribed, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.